Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Greetings to you in the name of our Father, Son Jesus Christ, and Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters, I welcome you all to this live program. I hope you are all doing well by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. I am blessed. You are blessed. We are all blessed. We are all blessed to be a blessing to all the people around this world. From past 6 weeks, we are meditating. We are discussing about God, our Lord Jesus Christ. Today, once again, I welcome you. I thank you all who are watching the live program and who are encouraging me by watching and by calling us and by sending your compliments and messages. I humbly, wholeheartedly thank you all. Today, let's meditate. Let's go and meditate about 5 loaves and 2 fishes. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's turn our Bible to John chapter 6, verse 1, from verse 1.
After these things, Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Here it is written that after these things means which things? If we search this, if we do little search, in John chapter 6 and John chapter 5, we can see that there is a little gap. There is a little gap when we compare to another gospels written by Matthew, Mark and Luke. So when we see in Matthew's, the exact thing what happened before these things means after these things means King Herod beheaded or ordered to kill John the Baptist. You all know the story what happened. A dancer and her daughter did a little drama to they conspired to kill John the Baptist. So King Herod killed John the Baptist. So when Jesus heard that thing, when Jesus heard what happened to John the Baptist, you all know Jesus Christ and John the Baptist are relatives. And even more than that, John the Baptist baptized Jesus Christ, have given water baptism. They are all men of God. So Jesus Christ wanted to take some quiet time. Jesus Christ wanted to spend some time with Father. Jesus Christ wanted some rest. So we can see there that Jesus Christ went over the Sea of Galilee, and we can see that he went up to the mountains in chapter 3. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Here we can see that when Jesus moved up to the mountain, when Jesus went to that sea, when he opened his eyes, there literally many people, hundreds and thousands of people are following him, have followed him. And when Jesus opened his mouth, when Jesus opened his eyes, Jesus saw multitudes of people. And there we can see a sentence. Let's read the fourth verse.
Now the Passover,
now the
feast of the Jews, was near.
Continue.
Then Jesus lifted up his eyes, and seeing a great multitude coming toward him, he said to Philip, "Where shall we buy bread that these may eat?"
Hallelujah! Here we can see that Jesus, when Jesus saw they are coming towards him, he moved with compassion. Hallelujah! It is literally written that he moved with compassion. So when we see this exact thing, John the Baptist died. John the Baptist is very near to him, his relative, and he is the one who baptized Jesus Christ, and they are both man of God. Jesus Christ was little bit concerned about John the Baptist. Jesus Christ have moved up to the mountain, have went there to have a quiet time, to spend time with Father, to pray to Father, to talk to Father. But when he saw multitudes of people, he did not reject them, but he moved with compassion. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Shalom! We can see that Jesus Christ moved with compassion. That means he is concerned over you. He is concerned over people. He is thinking about you. He is always caring about you. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to remind you that Jesus Christ is not busy. Jesus Christ is not going to reject you, but he always, whenever you meet him, whenever you pray to him, whenever you talk to him, he moves with compassion. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Then we can see the story. He moved with compassion and he gave the spiritual food. In the other gospels, this is the only miracle which is recorded in four gospels, in all the gospels. So we can see that Jesus Christ gave the spiritual food. He spoke to them from so many hours. So these people, as it is a desert place, as it is away from the city, as there is no food available there, Jesus moved with compassion and he is asking to his disciples, provide some food. Here we can see, where shall we buy bread that these may eat? Hallelujah! He is not only concerned about your spiritual health being, but he is also concerned about your physical health. Praise the Lord! He is concerned about your physical wellness, my dear brothers and sisters. If you are in a problem, if you are in a situation where there is no help, if you are in a desert-like situation, there is Jesus Christ who moved with compassion, who wants to provide food for you. Praise the Lord! Then here we can see that the disciples did not respond well. Jesus knew that there is no food which they can buy, because there is no shops there. For this many thousands of people, they cannot provide food. So why did Jesus tell like that? Why Jesus spoke to his disciples like that? Means there in John chapter 6 verse 6, we can see that he wants to test them. He tested them. What will be their response, or what is their spiritual status is. So there we can see the two people responded. We don't know, all the disciples might be responded, but we can see there two responses. One is from Philip and another is from Andrew. So Philip said that even 200 denarii worth of bread is not sufficient for them. So how can we buy the food for them? Philip responded like that. My dear brothers and sisters, God knows, Jesus knows very well that the food will not be available. Even if they have the money, they cannot buy the food. But Jesus spoke this sentence to test them, to test their spiritual status. Hallelujah. Here there is another response from another disciple, that is Andrew's is Simon Peter's brother. He said, there is a lad here who have 5 loaves and 2 fish, but even this may not be sufficient. Praise God. God said, even a seed amount faith is there, it will be sufficient to move the entire mountains from one place to another. Thank God, Andrew had a little faith there, and he is reporting to God that there are 5 loaves and 2 fish. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. This is the exact response what Jesus Christ is needed. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ got the response what he wanted from disciples. So we can see here two types of responses. One response is from Philip and another response is from Andrew. Philip is responding as a Gentile, but Andrew is responding as a spiritual person. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, we are in a situation. Many people may be in a situation, in a desert-like situation, where you don't have any hope, where you don't, even if you have money, you may not get what you need, where you are in a unconditional, where no help is there. So how are you responding to God? What is your response? How you are praying to God? This is the question. This is the thing which all of us should introspect ourselves. We should think ourselves how we are responding to God. If we are responding like Andrew, hallelujah, we are in a correct position. But if we are responding like Philip, my dear brothers and sisters, I want to tell you that you are responding not correctly to God. You are responding the way this physically people responds. But Andrew, the disciple of Jesus Christ, responded to God the way Jesus wanted. We can say one more thing. Andrew is the person who introduced Simon Peter to Jesus Christ. Well, Andrew is the one who testified Simon Peter that Jesus Christ is the Messiah. Praise the Lord. Jesus Christ is the Messiah. And here he introduced that lad. He reported that this lad had that food. So we can see that Andrew is the person who stands as a bridge for people and Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. We should also introduce people to Jesus, and we should also introduce Jesus Christ, the Messiah, to our friends and relatives. Are we doing that? My dear brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you all to be a bridge, to stand as a bridge between Jesus Christ and our neighbors, our friends, and our relatives. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! And here, I want to talk about this lad. This lad, he's a small kid. If we think, if I imagine myself, we don't know, we might be in a hungry situation, we might be feeling hungry, or we might not give that food to God. But here, this lad has a sparkle of faith. This lad has a little faith. He has faith. That's why he accepted. He gave that food to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Shalom. We should be like this lad. Even in the desert-like situation, God, he is having faith and he is giving that food, which is very less, to God. Praise the Lord. In even other instances, we can see an old woman have given the entire thing what she had and put in that offering box. When Jesus saw that, Jesus blessed her and he spoke, whomever may listen about me, they should also hear about this woman. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And today we are also hearing about this lad. Praise the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to tell, God does not want our ability, but he only checks our availability. Well, when we say no one has the ability what God have, we are all created by him, we are all inferior to him, so there is no want or there is no need for God about our ability, but God only wants who are available for him. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Today, God, because of God's grace, even though I don't have any ability, but as I am available to God, God is using me. Hallelujah. I am indebted to God. I am grateful to God. My dear brothers and sisters, you might be thinking that you don't have any talent. You might be thinking that you don't have any ability. But my dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, God's people, God does not want your ability, but God wants only your availability. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Shalom. Hallelujah. Don't discourage yourselves. Do not think or underestimate yourselves, but be available to God. Surrender yourselves. When you surrender to God, when you say to God, God, I am available to you, please use me, then God will surely use you in his mighty kingdom. He will surely use you according to his will. What is his will in your life? Praise God. And then let's go to the next verse. Here, when Andrew and this lad gave that food to Jesus Christ, you know what Jesus Christ did? Jesus Christ told to make them to sit in the lines, and the exact thing what God did is he lifted up that food and he thanked to Father. He gave thanks to Father for giving that food. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. My dear brothers and sisters, how many of you are grateful for what
we are today for what God gave to us. Well, the whole life, the very life we are living, the very breath we are breathing, the oxygen is given by God. This life, these clothes, this food, the shelter, everything is given by God. Still, some people are not thankful or not grateful to God, and they murmur, "My dear brothers and sisters, whatever you have, whatever the thing you possess is given by God. It's God's grace." We should always acknowledge God's grace and we should thank God. We should be grateful to Father. Then we can see in the next sentence that to all the 5,000 people, the food is sufficient. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And here in verse 11, we can see a sentence that we can say that the food is sufficient. The food they distributed is as much as they wanted. Praise the Lord. Here, disciples, when they distributed, they did not distribute them scarcely. They did not distribute them limitedly, but they gave the food. Jesus Christ, our Father, gives us as much as we want. Here, God gave the food. God blessed the food as they got very full. They got as much as they wanted. Our God is a God of abundance. Our God is a God of a blessing. We are always blessed so that we are not scared. We are not having any scarcity, but we are in abundance. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Are you experiencing abundance, my dear brothers and sisters? If you are not experiencing abundance, if you are not having full-fledged blessings, one thing I want to tell you is you should check whether you are thankful to God, whether you are grateful to God, whether you are thanking God every day, every moment of your life for whatever He has given to you. If you are thankful to God, if you are praising God, God will surely bless you with abundance, abundantly, that it will be more than sufficient. It will be as much as you wanted. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And then they were filled, and Jesus Christ told to disciples that whatever is the remaining, gather up the fragments. Here we can see that Jesus Christ is a person who has discipline. He is the one who got discipline. Our Father, our God, wants us to be disciplined in our life. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If we are not disciplined, if we are not following the rules and regulations of what God has given us, my dear brothers and sisters, maybe you are not having that blessings because you're not in the discipline. Here, our God is always the God of discipline. He always wants us to be disciplined. When we are disciplined, when we are grateful, when we are thankful, our God always blesses us. Our God always gives more than what we have. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And here we can see one more thing, that here the people testified that He is the prophet. In chapter 6 verse 14, this is truly the prophet who is to come into the world. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Our Father, our God, Jesus Christ, He is not only the prophet, but He is the apostle, He is the prophet, He is the pastor, He is the teacher, and He is the evangelist. He fulfilled the fivefold calling. He fulfilled everything. He is the chief priest. He is the shepherd. He is the miracle worker. He is the creator. He is everything to us. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If you are thinking that you don't have a friend, my dear brothers and sisters, you have a true friend called Jesus Christ. If you are thinking you don't have a father, my dear brothers and sisters, you have a father, and He is Jesus Christ. If you are thinking that you don't have a comfort, you don't have a strength, my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ sent the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, onto this earth to comfort you, to guide you, to strengthen you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Even though these people have testified that He is the prophet, and even though Andrew knew that He is the Messiah, when we see in the other chapter, when we see in the upcoming chapters, there we can see that one more miracle happened to 7,000 people. There, even there, disciples did not acknowledge, or disciples did not remind, did not remember that Jesus Christ had done many miracles. He is the one who does miracles, so He is also going to do a miracle. Disciples forgot again and again. Disciples forgot each and every time, and Jesus Christ reminded, or Jesus Christ did the miracles again and again. But sadly, disciples did not remember that He is the one who is the Messiah, that He is the one who does miracles. So my dear brothers and sisters, I want to remind you all that in our lives, when we search, in our lives, when we see ourselves, we experience many, many, many miracles. We experience many, many, many blessings in our lives. But still, if a problem arrives, if a situation arrives, we immediately forget that we have a God who does miracle. We have a God who does supernatural things. We forget it, and we look onto the mountains. We look to the political leaders here and there. My dear brothers and sisters, God did many miracles in our life. But when a problem persists, when a problem comes, why we are not remembering Him? Why we are not asking Him? Why we are not praying Him with the first priority? Why we are not acknowledging Him that He is the God, He is the supernatural God who can turn from any situation to an abundant, a blessing situation? Hallelujah. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to remind you all that we should remember that we have a supernatural God. Whatever the situation may be, whatever the thing may be, whatever the problem we are experiencing, we have a God who is able to turn all our problems into a solution. Turn all our scarcity into an abundance. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Shalom. My dear brothers and sisters, lastly, I want to read Luke chapter 6, verse 38. let's read Luke chapter 6 verse 38.
Give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over will be put into your bosom. For with the same measure that you use, it will be measured back to you.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Here we can see the promise of God. The promise what God is giving to us means, give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over will be put into your bosom. For with the same method that you use, and it will be measured back to you. My dear brothers and sisters, even in the Old Testament, we can see Elisha asked to that woman, the widow, what she had. She told that she had little dove and oil. When Elisha prayed and blessed her, the small quantity was available for the entire the year. Here, God is also telling, give and it will be given to you. Here, the little lad had given five loaves and two fishes, and God had blessed it to for 5,000 men. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. How God fed Israelites in the Egypt. He literally blessed them. He literally gave food from the sky. He gave manna to them. But here God is asking to the disciples that, is there something? Even Elisha asked like that. It's God's principle. It's God's way, it's God's standard that give and it will be given to you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We may think that we are in a situation that we cannot give anything. But my dear brothers and sisters, there will be something that you can give to Lord. There is a person, you are the one you can give to God. There will be something that will be given to God. And we should also can think like that. If I have only 1 rupee left, so when God asks me, there can be two responses. There can be two mindsets. If you have only 1 rupee, if I give this 1 rupee to God, I will have 0 rupees. So I cannot live. But there will be another mindset, that is, if I give 1 rupee to God, God will bless me and God will give me 100 rupees, then I will have 100 rupees. That is called faith. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God wants this faith. When you have faith in God, when you have trust in God, when you believe in God, whatever the situation may be, you have something to give to God. It's not only money, it's our time, it's our talent, it's everything, our time, our money, whatever we have, when we give that to God, God will bless us, God will bless that, and we will have abundance. We will be blessed to be a blessing. Hallelujah. Here, this lad gave only five loaves and two fish, and it was sufficient, and there are 12 baskets left. Hallelujah. 12 baskets means there is more than five loaves and two fish. If the lad carries it to his home, it will be more than five loaves and two fish. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That means God will bless you and it will be a blessing to many people. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to remind you, I want you to remember that give and it will be given. Praise the Lord. Let's close our eyes and let's close the program with prayer. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for giving this time, Lord. Oh Father, because of your grace, Lord, because of your one and only begotten Son, because of his sacrifice, today we are here, Lord. We are saved by your grace. We are healed by your stripes, Lord. Lord, thank you for giving this opportunity to meditate about you, Lord. Father, I humbly come into your presence. I humbly pray behalf of all the people who are watching, who are believing you, who are having faith you, Father. Father, whatever the situation they are in, Father. Father, whatever the problem they have, Father. But you are the one, the supernatural God, who can turn every situation into a praising situation, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for having. Thank you for giving the comforter, the guider, Holy Spirit, Lord. Lord, as you turn from 5 loaves and 2 fishes and fed them to multitudes of people, Lord. Lord, I surrender. I humbly come into your presence and we surrender ourselves into you, Father. Lord, we don't have any ability, but Father, we are available to you, Father. Father, we are available to you, Father. Father, use us, Lord. Lord, God, use us how we want to use, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, whatever the situation, whatever the sickness, whatever the unhealthy, whatever the infirmity they are experiencing, Father, Lord, I command each and every sickness to go out of their body, Father. By your stripes we are healed. Because of your blood, Father, we are healed. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus Christ, Lord. Lord, give them your faith, Lord. Lord, you said, give and it will be given, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Lord, give them your faith. Give them your trust so that they should trust you. They should believe you and they should give whatever they have, the time, the money, everything to you, Father. Lord, our first priority should be you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Lord, I once again, Lord, thank you. And we surrender each and every one of us into your hands, Father. Lord God, bless us and Lord, guide us, Lord. And we pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. My dear brothers and sisters, I thank you all for watching this program. If you're really blessed, please share this program, subscribe this program, and share with your friends. And if you have any prayer requests, please feel free to call to us, because we have a prayer tower. El Shaddai Prayer Tower is praying for you from morning, early morning to midnight. We are always ready to pray to you. We are ready to minister to you. Feel free to contact us. And if it is God's will, we will meet you again the next week. Until then, take care. Goodbye. God bless you.